room, you know, one of them will have breast cancer within their lifetime, statistically.
1 in 8, that is about a 13% chance for some women, and it's even higher than that.
And the disease doesn't discriminate. Just earlier this week, the governor's office announced Florida's first lady, Casey DeSantis, is battling breast cancer. She's 41 years old.
Yeah, so young. This Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we at ABC 7 are highlighting a group impacted by breast cancer in a unique way. Some call themselves previvors.
In tonight's cover story, ABC 7's Megan Miller gets us more on what that means, sharing stories from two Lee County women.
Jenna Sicato is a stay-at-home mom to her two little girls.
This is Marin, she's 2.
Inside their Estero home, you'll see lots of pink.
This is Aura, she's 8 months.
We've always been really big in the community as far as breast cancer awareness.
When Jenna was younger, her aunt was diagnosed with breast cancer.
She passed away after battling it for many years.
Then, 5 years ago, after finding a lump during an at-home self-exam, Jenna's mom was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer.
They decided to do chemo first before, and I had 16 rounds of chemo.
Her doctor also recommended genetic testing.
Doing the testing for the BRCA gene, it came back that I had BRCA1.
The BRCA gene mutations are just some of many that can increase your cancer risk. These are the ones most commonly linked to breast and ovarian cancers.
That prompted all of her daughters to get tested. Found out I was BRCA gene 1 positive.
Jenna was the only one out of her 5 sisters to have it.
So when I first found out about the BRCA genetic mutation, I was very isolated. Like, I felt alone. You know, I don't have cancer, but I have this heaviness.
First, it was a matter of helping her mom through her battle. Then, she had choices to make.
So I get monitored every 6 months, and, you know, in the next couple years, once me and my husband are done having kids, I'll have a double mastectomy and a hysterectomy. Making that decision on your own was hard. Like, okay, I have to decide to have my breast removed. But I will say, after nursing 2 kids, it's like a perk to get my boobs done, if I can say that. So I have that to look forward to. I'm trying to look at the positive part of it.
Excuse me?
Paige Hattie can relate to those highs and lows.
I found out that I had a gene mutation about 2.5 years ago. My lifetime risk of breast cancer was 87% with the BRCA2 mutation.
She too found out after her mom's diagnosis and genetic testing.
Our family had no history, no known history of breast cancer. I was 29 years old at the time. I went through mammograms, I went through breast ultrasounds, I went through everything, psychological exams.
Then for her, the timing seemed right to go a step further.
So I decided to take action and got a preventative double mastectomy with reconstruction surgery too.
Do you like my song?
We love your song.
Her procedures went well, and her mom beat cancer.
Hello.
Hello. My friends at ABC wanted to say hi to you.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Her connection with Paige is one you can see instantly, and it's only grown deeper.
She blows my mind. I'm so incredibly proud of her and the choices that she's made for her health.
But both she and Jenna's mom will tell you they've also battled guilt.
It was tough. It still is. It still is. And she's stronger than me. And I, you know, I prayed and prayed that it wouldn't happen to the other 4 children.
As a mother herself, it's a feeling Jenna now carries too.
There is that heaviness that they're going to have to go through what I'm going through one day.
But to get through it, she started searching and found a community. Some call themselves previvors, survivors of a predisposition to cancer.
It's hard because you don't want to take away from the people that actually do have breast cancer or are fighting through that.
It comes with a different type of battle, but also empowerment.
I mean, I think knowledge is power at the end of the day, right?
I want to thank Paige and Jenna for sharing their stories, which also gave me the privilege to connect them. It's also important to note men can have breast cancer and carry genes that create higher risks too, but the overall risk is higher for women. That's why monthly self-exams and annual mammograms are crucial for all women 40 and up.
Anybody can get breast cancer, so I don't have a family history, therefore I don't need to do a mammogram.
That was Dr. Robin Osborne, a radiologist at Fawcett Memorial Hospital in Port Charlotte. They just got a brand new sensory suite with new technology designed to make mammograms more comfortable.
We were actually going for just a very tranquil, spa-like atmosphere. We want our patients to be nice and relaxed because it can be a little stressful when you're having a mammo done.
The genetic testing can also be stressful too, and each person's journey will look different. We have a lot more information about when to know if you should consider genetic testing and more on support groups for people with BRCA genes and other hereditary risks. That's on our ABC7 News app and website. In studio, Megan Miller, ABC7.